something really gonna, I mean, can you tell us more about what are the obstacles they're gonna face and how do you, you know, find a way to conquer those obstacles?
Okay. I think the first obstacle is mindset.
The mindset?
Yes.
The belief.
Because the African mind, and I'm sorry, it's a TV show, but I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah.
The African mindset, when they are in Germany, they're just happy to be in Germany.
Yeah.
So they'll take the any job that comes.
Happiness.
Because they are in Germany. Germany. You know. The German mindset is that we don't know any African entrepreneurs. Why do you want to be an African entrepreneur? Why do you want to be an entrepreneur? Why can't you just do that job that is there? So it's both sides. So for me, when I came here initially, because I was still learning the language, I was...
Guten Tag, ihr Lieben. Herzlich willkommen zu der CD-Show heute. Mein Gast des Tages ist Kumbirai aus Hannover. Und Kumbirai ist einer der Migranten, die Entrepreneur in Deutschland sind. Und es freut mich auf jeden Fall, Kumbirai, dass du hier seid. Und kannst du gerne für die Zuschauer vorstellen, wer du bist, was du magst zum Beispiel oder wo du gerade wohnst?
Okay. Vielen Dank, Sidi. Aber Sie haben eine Mistake gemacht.
Ja.
Ich bin von Sassenburg.
Sassenburg.
Ja, das ist ein kleines Dorf im Gifhorn Landkreis. Ja.
Ah, Landkreis so, Gifhorn ist das?
Ja, ich bin Sassenburger.
Sassenburger. Oh mein ja. Gott. Er ist aus Sassenburg. Ich dachte, du bist aus Hannover.
Vielen Dank. Ja. Ja. Aber ja, so mein Name ist Kumbirai Chipadza. Ich komme aus Zimbabwe. Jetzt ich habe 5 Jahre im November in Deutschland.
Mhm.
Ich bin 38 Jahre alt, ich bin verheiratet, habe 2 Kinder und ja, ich bin ein Unternehmer und meine Firma heißt Deutsch Connect. Wir machen Geschäfte zwischen afrikanischen Unternehmen und deutschen Unternehmen. Wir machen auch, wir sind ein, was auf Deutsch, Bridge between Africa and yeah. Germany. Ja. Verbindung, ja, und wir machen B2B Matchmaking, wir machen Zugang zum Markt, wir machen auch Talent Acquisition.
Ihr seid einfach wie ein Brücke
ja,
zwischen Afrikaner und Deutschen.
Ja, ja, das ist richtig, ja. Ja, so das, ich denke, das ist mein...
Yeah. Ja. Ladies and gentlemen, you heard him. He is Kumbirai. He's an entrepreneur in Germany. He's a migrant, of course, and a refugee. As he came here. But before we go further, because I would like to speak with him, both English and German, because I think that's where you can competently speak the way you want it. And therefore, I am very humble today, and it's an honor to have you today on CD Show. And once again, before we go further to your business ideas, what you have done in Germany, I'm going to start it with. How did you come to Germany? Warum bist du nach Deutschland gekommen? What was your reason? Was ist dein Grund, dass du nach Deutschland fliegst?
Ja, das ist eine gute Frage. Aber ja, jetzt, ich habe B2 Deutschergebnis, aber vor 3 Jahren, ich bin Unternehmer zwischen Deutschland und Afrika und wir sprechen Englisch. Ja, so jetzt ich habe mit Corona auch habe nicht viel Kontakt mit anderen Personen. Ja, so das tut mir leid.
Ja. Ja. Ist okay, ist okay. Ja, okay. Ganz ehrlich, hier, wir haben hier Vielfalt.
Mm.
So we also ja. Want to introduce, promote diversity in
diversity,
media.
Ja.
So it's okay if you want to speak English. So I'm very open to it.
Yeah, so maybe to answer you, yeah. I came to Zimbabwe, to Germany in 2016 as a refugee because of the political situation that was there in Zimbabwe. My family was involved in politics.
Political issues.
And what was happening on the ground was very difficult for us. I came with my wife. We left our kids in Zimbabwe.
Oh.
Yeah, my daughter was 13, my son was 3 when we left them. So it was very difficult. So we just had to leave everything and come to Germany and start over. Why we came to Germany was because my wife, in a role in politics, had also worked with German people in the constituency that she was working for,
yeah.
And the German ambassador was there at that time. So that is why Germany became our first point of call. And at that time as well, Germany was also a country that was welcoming refugees and migrants.
Yeah.
So I think the German people, I think, the Germans for giving us our lives back, because we're coming from a very, very difficult
situation
and point. Yeah, so that's why I came to Germany.
Damn, that must be a very difficult thing to leave your kids behind and run away for your life. And so how is it coming to Germany as a refugee and your kids are down there with all the situation? Mm. And how is that for you and your wife?
If that's what I was saying. Yeah, as a man, you become emasculated, you know.
Yeah.
Because you're coming to a new country where before you were taking care of your family. Now you're coming into a refugee camp. You don't even know what's happening tomorrow. You can't speak the language. Even if your wife is asking you questions, you can't answer her questions because you have no answers,
sure.
You know. So it was tough. It was very, very tough, not knowing what's happening in the future, not knowing what is the situation with our children back home. Even now, my son is now 8, he's now here. He always says, in joking, you abandoned us for 3 years. So those are big words coming from a child, you know. He thought we abandoned
him.
Yeah, so it was not a good time. But time is also the equalizer. It's also now, when we look at where we are in our lives, then we also see the benefits as well of actually coming to Germany at the time that we came, yes.
And now you're with your family, finally.
Yes, after all our paperwork was done in 2019, we were able to bring our children. So yeah, if my children, if they were here, they speak Zeze good Deutsch.
Nice, that's our kids.
Yeah.
Kids are always smart and they have no problem in their brain. So I guess it will be easier for them to speak the German language.
Yeah.
You live in, this is Kumbirai, it's our Zimbabwe. Kumbirai meet a Frau, or seine Frau. Die hat in Zimbabwe verlassen wegen politischer Situation in Zimbabwe. Die sind nach Deutschland gekommen als Geflüchtete. Und deswegen Kumbirai ist hier gekommen. Und was da schade ist, dass Kumbirai mit deiner Frau oder ihr Frau, die hatten ihre Kinder in Zimbabwe gelassen. Ne?
Ja.
3 Jahre später und die Kinder sind auch nach Deutschland gekommen. Und das ist die positive Nachricht. Das ist gerade gekommen. Über ihre ganzen Familiensituation. Ja, das ist die Geschichte von Kumbirai, warum er nach Deutschland kommt. Und jetzt, we're gonna continue to talk about the business idea. What is the most important? Das ist die Deutsche Connection.
Yeah.
Because this is Stärker zusammen.
Yeah.
I'm seeing that in your T-shirt.
Yeah.
Tell me more about how did you come with this business idea? Tell me about that.
Okay, so before I came to Germany, I've always been an entrepreneur. I've got more than 13 years.
You were a business entrepreneur in Zimbabwe?
Yeah, in Zimbabwe. Firstly, not even in Zimbabwe. I went to university in South Africa.
University?
In university, I was an entrepreneur.
Yeah.
Before I went to university, when I was 19, I was already working for my mother as an entrepreneur in Zimbabwe.
Wow.
Then it's something that is inborn in me.
It's in you.
So, yeah, in Zimbabwe, we opened the first online butchery that was called Something Meaty, which was servicing Zimbabweans in the diaspora who wanted to buy for their families back in Zimbabwe.
Yeah.
So it was an online, back in 2014.
Online shop, yeah.
That was one of the biggest things we did. We also did a TV show called My Own Boss, where we had, it was a reality show, where we would bring in like 10 young entrepreneurs.
Mm-hmm.
Then sort of like Donald Trump's The Apprentice. Mm-hmm. Then every week we'll chuck one out until we had a winner. So yeah, I've been in the entrepreneurship field for a long time. So Deutsch Connect, why Deutsch Connect? So when I came to Germany, a lot of people back home were saying, yeah, in Germany, you know, there were so many negative connotations about Germany, you know, because sometimes we don't know the correct information.
Sounds.
Then at the same time, German people also had they think Africa is one country.
Yeah.
Or they think you stay beside the lion in Africa, you know. So I felt that there was so much lack of information between Africans and Germans.
German.
So they needed a bridge that brought the two together. But at the same time, I realized that Germany was only doing 2% of its trade.
It's in Africa.
In Africa. And Germany is the third or the fourth largest economy in the world.
Yeah.
It's the leading economy in the EU. And also then in 2017, that is when Germany started the Marshall Plan for Africa, where it was now incentivizing German companies that wanted to do business in Africa. So I would say I was in the right place at the right time. Yeah. So I felt that being an African, I was the one that was supposed to connect Germany to Africa. Okay. So that is Deutsch Connect.
So that was the reason why you bring up this name, Deutsch Connect.
Yes.
It could have been Deutsch Africa Connect. It could have been Deutsch nach Africa. Right. But amazing. I mean,
yeah, that's,
that makes sense.
Then Stärker zusammen, that's just, we're stronger together. We're stronger
together. Together we can make
yeah,
more.
Yeah.
That's
cool. I think it's also, we have an African proverb that alone you can make it, but we go further
together.
You know. So that's where it also comes from as well. Yeah.
That's great, bro. I mean, like, this is very important. Mm. You have this business mindset in you. You build yourself. You were in it in Africa. You came here. And with obstacles, you find out that you're in the right place in the right time. And there's now German are facing now, you know, targeting Africa and as their next target when it comes to business, you know. And you see that you have to do something, you know, not just for the Africans, but for also Germany and for yourself. So tell me, how is that for you? That obstacle, because I know within that year, 3-4 years in Germany, there will be so many obstacles you're gonna face. As a refugee, as a refugee here, it's not just really easy. The language barrier is gonna be there. There are gonna be so many things that you're gonna face. Even the trust you're gonna gain from the German, counterpart is gonna be something different. Something really gonna, can you tell us more about what are the obstacles they're gonna face and how do you, you know, find a way to conquer those obstacles?
Okay. I think the first obstacle is mindset.
The mindset?
Yes.
The belief.
Because the African mind, and I'm sorry, it's a TV show, but I'm going to be honest with you.
Yeah.
The African mindset, when they are in Germany, they're just happy to be in Germany.
Yeah.
So they'll take the any job that comes.
Happiness.
Because they are in Germany. You know. The German mindset is that we don't know any African entrepreneurs. Why do you want to be an African entrepreneur? Why do you want to be an entrepreneur? Why can't you just do that job that is there? So it's both sides. So for me, when I came here initially, because I was still learning the language, I was also trying to integrate. I worked at Edeka, Eat Center, in the back of, so that's where I was also training my German language there.
Yeah.
But I was doing a job that I was not happy with, But the people that helped me get that job, the German people, they wanted me to be happy because I'm doing that job. But they didn't know who I was back in my country.
Yeah.
You know, so you'd be sort of like fighting the people that are helping you. It was sort of like contradictory. Then you come to your African friends, relatives and all that, they think you're lazy because you don't want to go to work like everyone else. They never think that it's possible for an African to make it as an entrepreneur.
Here.
So it's the mindset. For me, that's the number one.
Yeah.
So with this mindset now, it's difficult for you then to even tell your German friends or helpers to say, can you give me 5,000 or 10,000 to start a business? Because they've never known any African who's done business. You know, your African friends, you can't even start that story with them, you know. So a lot of people, I know there are a lot of people with ideas, but the ideas are dying because they are scared of what people will say.
Scared to take the risk.
Yeah, scared to take the risk. But at the end of the day, people are doing jobs that they are unhappy with. And I feel that's wrong for the next generation, for our children. Because our children cannot just see us doing menial jobs. They have to have role models. They have to have people they look up to. Imagine in America, 50 years ago, no one would have thought someone like Barack Obama would have been the president. So we need more people to lead. And by leading, you take risks. You can't just lead by doing what everyone else is doing.
Wow.
So that is, for me, that is the most important. I mean, when you start a business, obviously, we talk about the three types of starting a business. You bootstrap, that's your own money. You go to friends and family before you even look for funding or investors. So you find your friends and family don't give you money. You don't have any money. There's no funding. Then the system itself, the Deutsch system is very, very anti-migrant when it comes to funding, which is the reality. And I'm a point of a good example because you'd find in Niedersachsen in our province, we have the N Bank that gives every startup like 10,000 to start your company.
Mm-hmm.
But if you're a migrant now and you go and you want to get that 10,000, they will tell you that you are a flight risk because your papers are going to expire as a migrant.
Grant, yeah.
So they are allowing you to start a company, but they are not allowing you to get the benefits. So it's more like systematic discrimination, you know. So there are roadblocks, like I want to say, in every stage. So that for me, that is the biggest obstacle, that in terms of funding for migrants and the mindset, even if you go to your local Landkreis or the job center, you want to tell them, I want to start a company, like they look at you as if you're crazy.
Yeah.
And I experienced this, I'm talking about myself. So I feel that a lot of people could have been doing bigger things if they had
support.
Yeah.
Well, you said something about the systematic discrimination,
yes,
which is true. We all know we are not sleeping. I think people, not everybody will be bold to say this, but that's true.
That's true.
It's, we in Germany, so everybody Germany, have
it's
right
a,
to speak
it's a democracy,
right,
you
know? So, my friend, that's ganz ehrlich, das ist wahr. Ladies and gentlemen, zu meiner liebe Zuschauer, erzähl nur über ihre Geschäfte. Wie hat er angefangen mit ihren Geschäften? Die Idee war da, hat er vorher in Zimbabwe angefangen als eine Businessperson. Und jetzt, als er nach Deutschland gekommen, Deutschland hier, die haben eine neue Gesetze für die Afrikaner und auch die hatten auch gesagt, okay, Deutschland müssen wir nach Afrika auch gehen für Business und Geschäfte und sowas. Und da gibt es die Möglichkeit, und er hat ja gesagt, okay, ich glaube, ich bin in der richtigen Platz, in dem richtigen Moment, wo ich auch was machen kann. Dann hat er angefangen, seine Businessgeschäfte, Ideal zusammen zu, dann Business Ideal hier in Deutschland zu machen. Und jetzt, der hat deine Deutsche Connect aufgebaut und Afrikaner und Deutsche zusammen zu vernetzen. Und gerade, er fängt an mit diesem Gesetz, aber er meinte, es gibt nur drei Obstacles, was er hier leben kann. Und vor auch die anderen Leute, die als Ausländer oder Migranten hier in Deutschland sind. Der Mindset, das ist wie die Gedanken haben, also die Gedanken von die Geflüchteten. Und zwar das Geld, ob das kommt von ihr, also ihr Geld oder von der Familie. Und die dritte ist das von der Staat oder vom Bank zum Beispiel. Und das ist, wo man sagt, es ist schwer, man solche Dinge zu haben. Aber wenn man das haben kann, dann hast du deine Chance, hier eine gute Geschäft zu haben. We're going to continue. I'm just saying this for the people who are watching me.
Yeah, I understand.
My German is not good like you.
No.
I think they're going to understand all what we're going to say.
Yeah.
But what's important now is that I just want to know, how did you raise your funding for your venture? How did you get that funding? Because you talk about the obstacles. Mm. You talk about how to get the money from the state is difficult. If you tell your friends, a colleague, German friend, they will think that you're mad. Mm. Where is this person talking about? What is he talking about? You know, so there are so many obstacles, I would say. People are going to try to discourage you because you have a great idea, but they believe that you can't succeed with that idea here. But how did you finally get your funding? Where do you get your funding?
No funding.
No funding?
No funding. This is self-standish. Myself, my family, myself and my wife, my children, sacrifices in the family. We could have been spending more money with my family. I put money to the business. I've dug a lot of money into this business over the past 3 years as I was starting it. And sometimes I actually feel sorry for my family, you know, because the people, when they look at you, when they see this, they think he's got money, you know, but they don't know the suffering my family goes through for me to get to where I am, to have this brand, to have this image here. So there's been no funding, none whatever. Until now, there's a company called Lead Africa, together with Baden-Württemberg State.
Yeah.
So I was chosen as one of 15 out of about 400 people that are going to get grant funding. And it's we went through a workshop last week. So the funding is supposed to come in the next 6 weeks. So that would be the first real funding that's coming into the company. So far, I've also heard from, of course, my mentors. One of my mentors has also sort of come in as a bit of a business angel recently. Mm-hmm. So otherwise, I had to make a business model that was very not capital intensive, low on money, but big on output. You know, so we don't really need a lot of money in what we do. We use social media and things like that. Then also because of Corona, we didn't have to travel a lot, But now we are building a platform where we want to get people in Africa, people in Germany, all on one platform, whether they're looking for B2B matchmaking, whether they're looking for market linkages, whether they're looking for talent acquisition, or whether they're looking for investment. I'll tell you a small story. I actually had some German investors who came to us with 100,000 euro. They were looking to invest in an African startup through us. So imagine you actually won the 100,000 euro, but these guys are saying, can you find an African startup in Africa we can give this money to? So we did a pitch event, and there was a winner, a startup from Uganda. So for me, it was also big, you know.
For you, yeah.
Yeah, because it's 100,000 coming from people that don't know you. And they're saying, look, through your organization, through your business, find us the correct people that we can invest in.
They can invest in and they can work as a business partner.
Yes.
Wow, 100,000 euros.
100,000 euros, yes.
Bro, if if anybody has that in Africa, that's business starting.
That's big.
That's something not big. That's huge.
Yeah, because sometimes you find in Africa, it's not about a lot of money, but it's about technology. It's about just needing
materials.
That's what they need. Yeah. So because African people, because we have so many problems, they have so many innovative solutions.
Yeah, solutions. Yeah.
So many innovation solutions that sometimes that 5,000, that 10,000, can change a business.
Everything. Yeah.
In Africa, so I'm very much someone who's big in investing in young, early stage African entrepreneurs, and I think because of the COVID situation, Africa has actually shown that it can solve its own problems. And I want to be the one that takes these young African entrepreneurs and put them into the German-European ecosystem altogether.
Wow, brother.
Yeah.
Congrats, that's amazing.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
That's one thing that you should be proud of.
Definitely.
The Deutsch Connect, now I sense the idea of this Deutsch Connect now. Yeah. You know, you are not just trying to, you know, have a business for yourself to gain money only, but you want to make sure that you give opportunity to young people
Impact.
Who down in Africa, people who are sacrificing their way, you know, to the Middlemeer, so the Mediterranean Sea, to come to Europe. When they have the opportunity, the business idea, they can even make it there than here. You know, and I've even seen in your website that you even give people the idea how they can come to Europe when they have, they have talents, you know, with professionals come to Germany in a very easy way, 6 months to find a job.
Yeah.
And all those things, you know, is something amazing because something that, you know, you're not just trying to find just money, but you're trying to help.
No, for me, I'm looking into impact. Especially more, I work with a lot of women more than men, because if you empower a man, you empower his family.
Yeah.
But if you empower a woman, you empower a village or a nation. So that's what we also look at a lot. Like you're saying, one of the key things we're doing is the talent acquisition.
Yes, yeah.
So one thing that I learned was that a lot of Africans don't speak Deutsch.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be difficult for Africa and Germany to really connect in that way.
Yeah.
So we started doing German language courses,
mm-hmm.
Physically in Zimbabwe, with qualified teachers and certification from Goethe Institute.
Wow.
Then now, because of the COVID situation, we went online. So people can learn online via Zoom. People can also learn, you know, WhatsApp is very big in Africa.
Yeah.
People can actually learn more on WhatsApp because it doesn't take a lot of internet. For young people in Africa. So we are teaching a lot of young people. And now, for example, the German government has said that it's looking for 400,000 workers per year who are coming not from the EU, from outside
the EU. Outside the EU, countries.
Yes. So these are both skilled and unskilled
skilled workers.
We have a lot of young people in Africa who have got to university who are just sitting.
Mm-hmm.
So we are also now pushing for what we call smart migration.
Migration.
Yes, because I've always believed that migration on its own.
I can remember that's an MMM workshop.
Yes, that's migration on its own is not bad, but it is the type of migration. Yes, because migration has always been there throughout the world.
Oh, it won't change.
And if you look at migrants the world over, are the people that take all those countries to the next level. If you look in the world in terms of entrepreneurs, the most successful entrepreneurs at the moment, your Elon Musk, they're migrants. They're migrants.
Yeah, claro.
And like we talked before, migrants take risks, number one.
Mm-hmm.
Migrants bring a new culture,
yeah,
a new way of doing things. They also bring a new network that was not there before.
Yeah.
You know. So migrants are very, very important in terms of building companies, building countries as well, as the world has learned. So definitely we advocate for smart migration. We are looking towards partnering with the Niedersachsen government. I was in IHK, Hanover recently. We're talking to them in terms of, can there be a quota system whereby young Africans can come, those that are skilled, that have the language, can they come legally or regularly to do jobs that are there, you know?
Yeah.
And people talk about brain drain, you know, to say, but if we take these young people from Africa, Africa is not going to develop. No, that's not true. If these young people come to these first world countries, they develop knowledge and skills, they then remit money back home, number one. That money is helping families, helping communities. But more importantly, the networks that they get, the knowledge, the skills that they can be able to return back home. For me, it's not brain drain, it's brain gain, you know. So that's what I believe in.
Bro, you're not just an entrepreneur. You are just a big advocate and a social media influencer, trust me.
Yeah.
You, right now, I have enough to say. I don't know what to say. Nonetheless, we don't have much time to waste, but I am totally proud of you, and I hope that we all see you as a role model, because what you're saying is reality, and that is exactly how things work here. So before going further, I would really like to ask this question. You know, you talk about how you build your successful customer base. What are your goals? What do you guys want to do? How your biggest ideas? You know, you told us how, why you bring us. You know, you choose this name Deutsch Connect, and what you guys are doing. And if I may ask, if there are migrants here today, they want to start a business today as an entrepreneur, what do you think should be first, second step they have to take right now? I mean, and there are going to be people watching you, and they're going to be very interested to start, and they're going to be going through obstacles, like you said, and there are obstacles, thousand obstacles that people are going to face. But what do you think you're going to advise them as a tip? Let them start it from that day.
Okay, thanks. Yeah, I like, this is a topic I like. For me, the first thing, obviously, it's not about migrants, it's not about any, it's just about entrepreneurship. You need to do something that you have a passion for. You don't have to do things that is popular with everyone. Everyone is doing it. No. You have to be passionate about whatever you want to do. Because if you're not passionate, it's a lonely journey as an entrepreneur.
Mm-hmm.
Very lonely nights. People only like it when you're successful. When you're now coming on these programs with CD, that's when people say, okay. But there are so many sleepless nights questioning whether I'm doing the correct thing. You die many times before you succeed as an entrepreneur. Or like Abraham Lincoln, you lose 4 presidential elections before you win one, you know.
Yeah.
So you have to have passion for you to stay in the road. But for a migrant, like we said, you've already taken a risk in terms of coming to Germany, coming to a place you don't even know.
Mm-hmm.
Most of us came, our younger people came in through ways that are so terrifying, you know, that for me, I say, if you went through all that, then this is easier now.
This is way.
Yes.
Because you went through a lot.
But believe in yourself. Then what is also important is to change sort of like the people that you also hang around with. You need to hang around with people in the same mindset. Because if you're talking about being an entrepreneur with people that don't even think about that, they'll just kill it there.
No, they're going to laugh at you.
Then you need mentorship. You need people that have done it. People like myself, people like you who are already doing these things, you know. We talk to these young people, we advise each other, we create a network. Then for me, those are the most important things. But also in Germany, there are so many hubs, so many places to go as an entrepreneur that you can join. You know, if you're in university, most universities have these hubs. If you're not in university, they can also contact us, depending where they stay.
Mm-hmm.
I can give them the links, whether in Niedersachsen, whether in Berlin. There are so many where you can learn the knowledge and skills that you need to become a startup. Then we also do lectures. We also do workshops in terms of helping migrants to start businesses in Germany. So definitely, it's something I'm really passionate about. And to anyone who's watching, I challenge you, if you think it, do it.
But I think To me, example, I just really want to know more about this entrepreneurship because I think I'm going to get to these business issues because I wouldn't want to work the whole time, 8 hours, 12 hours. No. So I'm going to think like you think it. My friend, if you're watching me and you have this idea that you have something in you, you believe that it can work, that it could be work, it will work. As my brother said, the only thing is here,
mindset.
The mindset. If you believe in it, you believe in yourself, just find a way, find a mentor. And I just don't want to, because we don't have much time, but what I want to say is that anything is possible. They call us migrants, that's just a status. But we are migrants, but we're also human beings. And the same thing goes to anyone else living here. People from Italy, they're working, they have their restaurants here, they're migrants here. That's the same status. So which means, I'm also going to say this to anyone who is watching me. Anything you want to do in this world is possible. The only thing you can do it, the only way you can do it is to start it. How to start it is to believe in you and believe in your ideas. Find a one, somebody who will help you to start. And that's how it goes. You can't just be in your house and say, I have this, but you don't want to move on. It doesn't work like that. So dear brother, I don't want to see much, but we have more, we don't have much time, but I really want to invite you again to talk more about this because we have to talk to our people. We have to give these people that, you know, this feeling that they can do anything you want to do in this country because there is a possibility, there is a chance, there is a room for it. Yeah. And therefore, I just want to thank you. But before making the final sentence, I want to ask you, what do you want to say your final, I mean, for your, for the social who are watching you, what do you want to say for the last one?
I just want to say that I'm a real life example of failure and of hard work and believing in yourself. So to anyone watching, I strongly believe that Africans must not just accept being at the bottom. I strongly believe because it's going to take us another 200 years. You know, we need more role models. We need more role models in the big jobs. We need more role models in entrepreneurship. We need more role models in sports, in anything. You know, we need our children to grow up believing that they can be anything they want to be.
It can be top.
It doesn't matter whether in Africa, whether in Europe, whether in Germany, you can be whatever you want to be. And for me, those are the final words I want to, just before I need to give you your Deutsch Connect t-shirt. I think it might be a bit small.
I'm small,
bro.
But
if it's small, I'll also give you, you just tell me and give you another one.
Thank you so very much, bro. No. I appreciate that.
You're welcome.
Guys, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
So, as you can see right now, this is the Deutsch Connect I got from, thank you so very much, bro.
You're welcome.
I appreciate it. Now I'm part of your team.
Yeah, thank
you. And yeah, so ladies and gentlemen, in liebe Zuschauer, sind wir jetzt am Ende und wie gesagt, heute, unsere Zuschauer, entschuldigen, dass wir heute auf Englisch sprechen, aber ich glaube, hier haben wir auch schon viele Leute, die auch Englisch sprechen. Und auch für unsere alte Generation, jeder wollte einfach Englisch sprechen. Und der hat uns seine Leben erzählt, wie er nach Deutschland gekommen, wie hat er angefangen, seine Geschäfte zu aufbauen und welche Station ist er jetzt. Und er ist jetzt genau wie eine iconic Figur für uns als Migranten und Geflüchtete in Deutschland. Und therefore, thank you so very much for your time. And I hope so that my liebe Zuschauer will enjoy the show.
Vielen Dank.
Thank you so very much.
Vielen Dank.